Kelly Kyla, it is just heartbreaking being out here. It's painful. We're speaking to the families who lost their friends and their loved ones. Right now, we just spoke to Amanda Ferguson's friends, and they're here, and they're gathered here where many families have come to put flowers at the scene of where this crash happened. Amanda's friend who I talked to said, you know, she and all of the kids that were inside that car, they were full of life. The woman I spoke with, she cheered with Amanda since they've been friends since she was 6 years old. But this is what we've seen out here. We've seen a lot of families come out here to support one another. I've seen mothers just clench their hearts and drop to their knees, seeing the scene where their son or daughter, you know, died. I mean, these kids were 18, 19 years old. They had dreams. They had goals. Their whole lives were ahead of them. Four out of the five of them, you know, worked at Texas Roadhouse. And it's just heartbreaking being out here and seeing these families and hearing these stories and hearing about these kids. Fort Myers police believe that the car came off this road, crashed right out there. You can see where that grass, if you're looking at it right there, where that grass is just down there, that's where Fort Myers officers believe that the car went straight through that grass, right off this road and into this retention pond. We have video from when officers, you know, pulled that car out. They got here and they pulled those kids out of the car. Officers tried doing CPR, but it was just too late. Now, we did speak with one of the fathers, Eric Cox's father. He tells us his son was 19 years old. We have a photo of him I want to show you guys. He played football. He was a wrestler. He wanted to be a firefighter. He wanted to save lives. From what I've gathered here is that these kids, they were loved by so many people. Their coworkers, they say, you know, these kids, they work together and they put a smile on their faces every single day. They made their days so much better. So it's just heartbreaking to see all these families in pain right now. And I do want to share what Eric Cox's father told us earlier today.
As a parent, you want your child to, you don't want your child to pass on before you. And now we're at this point where, you know, we're just dying over it. You know, we don't know where to go. We're just now another victim in the process of life, you know, another cycle of life, another process. We're just in the moment now, like every other family could be, but now it's our family.
It's just heartbreaking, you know, hearing from his dad. And I do want to point out this road that we're on, Topgolf Way, it's a very windy road. You can see that it curves right here. So Fort Myers police, they're still investigating this. They're still trying to figure out what happened that led to these teens going into this retention pond right near Topgolf. And once we get those answers, we'll be sure to bring it to you. But for now, reporting live and local in Fort Myers, Christy Soto, NBC2.
NBC2's Hope Salmon is at the Texas Roadhouse where four of the five teens worked. Hope, we know the restaurant is closed today and a memorial is growing outside the door. You spoke with the restaurant manager. What is he saying about this horrible loss?
It's just completely heartbreaking, Kelly. Yes, more than 200 people are inside right now, and I did speak to a manager. She says that she calls those four employees roadies, and they're all like family to each other. There is tears in almost everyone's eyes as they're walking up to the doors. There was someone that just passed by that was just coming from inside that says it's just the most heart-wrenching place to be right now as they're breaking bread inside right now. And we now know the four people who worked at Texas Roadhouse who lost their lives are Amanda Ferguson, Brianna Coleman, Eric Cox, and Jackson Ayer. The manager inside tells me that they knew the fifth person, and his name was Jesus. They do not have his last name right now. And we also want to just reiterate that everybody's inside right now. They are mourning this loss. They're going to stay closed all day today. They haven't decided if they will reopen tomorrow. But another manager that we also spoke to has some words that they wanted to share, and we're going to take that right now.
And we've had a lot of them since they were 16, and they've worked with us, and they've moved up the ranks. They know a lot of positions here and are a solid asset for our team and a part of our family. You know, we say it, you're a roadie for life. You know, they wear it on their jackets, on their shirts. I love my job. These four, they showed that. They loved what they did. They came in with a smile on their face, and, you know, they've probably served the majority of the Fort Myers community.
And like I said, there are so many tears out here. So many people are coming in with flowers. They're hugging each other. They're really just trying to mourn this loss. And all of the people that I did talk to that did not want to go on camera, who are family and friends, say that they just want this time to really reflect on the lives and the relationships that they shared and just understand how quickly they are no longer in their lives. I mean, this just happened overnight, and all of these people that love them, knew them, shared the memories with them, worked with them, are now learning how to continue life without them. And that is just something that is so hard to report on today. We're going to continue giving you all of the updates as we get them. I'm reporting live here in Fort Myers. Hope Salmon, NBC2.
NBC2 is working to learn more about the investigation. Fort Myers police are asking anyone with information on what might have happened to contact them. And you can download the free NBC2 News app to get breaking news alerts when we confirm details about the investigation.
Summer months are some of the most dangerous for teen drivers. AAA calls it the 100 deadliest days, and unfortunately we're feeling those impacts right here in our community. The travel agency says deadly crashes for young drivers dramatically increase between Memorial Day and Labor Day. Now, it's not just because they spend more time driving, it's how they drive with friends, usually without a destination. Research also shows if a teen driver has only other teenagers in the car, they are all 51% more likely to die in a crash. The state says last year more than 107,000 people got in car crashes just between June and July, and the majority of those drivers were between the ages of 18 and 33.